there, I'm Sarah, language learner and teacher, and today I'll be sharing how to learn grammar without studying it. We'll do this by looking at the fluency approach, and so make sure to stick around for the end of this video because there will be some bonus tips for you that you can apply today. The way that we learn grammar without studying it is the difference between practicing context and studying. So this is going to be our focus today within this lesson. This is comprised of two main components. This is the input, like reading and listening, and then the output of speaking and writing. So we're going to look more in depth into those two main categories, as well as a holistic approach to integrating everything, because of course we can't practice any one of those skills without practicing at least a little bit of all three of the others. But first, let's start with the fluency approach and what that is as the beginning of this topic. The fluency approach just means that we are practicing the language in context. So instead of using a grammar book and writing and doing drills and memorizing it that way, like many of us learned in high school to study a foreign language, learn the conjugations, learn the grammar, learn the vocabulary, memorize it, and then speak, and then write, and then try to use it. We're going the other way around. So we are learning phrases and sentences and words and just naturally acquiring these language pieces, even at the very beginning level, and naturally acquiring pieces of the grammar as well. So you may not even realize that you've learned grammar within that language, but by nature of learning how to produce sentences in that language, you are learning the grammar structures. You're just not necessarily learning how they function in a mathematical sense, but you are able to apply it and speak and have conversations and communicate, which is our goal in language learning. So let's jump in to our two main topics here, beginning with the way that input through listening and reading works. Is that we are learning the language through immersion, through absorbing the language by what we hear and what we read. And this works whether you're at the beginning stage or intermediate stage or advanced stage. If you're at the intermediate stage, like my French level, then this is an option. Reading a book, comic book is helpful because of all the pictures, but what I'm doing for my beginner language is Duolingo, and that I find to be just a better approach for me at the very beginning stage, and also still has the different components of listening and reading. Like here, I'll be reading the characters and then listening as I click on one of these, then it says, okay, this is Chang. And that's that component of listening and reading. And then as you go through there, then it'll show that some of them are in a sentence. So let's see, maybe this next one here. Okay, so this one is in a sentence. And in this component, it's listening and writing. So with that, then you have that listening component, that writing component, and then of course, in order to write, you must read. So this is my approach to a very beginner level. And the reason that this works to learn grammar, even though it's not teaching you, this grammar concept, like, conjugate these verbs, like, this is how you structure your sentence, where the verb goes and where the subject goes and everything else. It's teaching you by usage, which moves us to our goal of fluency faster, because how many times have you been in a conversation and you're like, oh, wait, what was that grammar lesson? Wait, what was that word? Wait, how do I conjugate that verb? And when you learn this other way, like with my Mandarin, I don't think about the grammar structures because I don't really know them that much. I know a few of them, and it's not really that important. What's important is that I can use the language. And the same thing works for French, for any language, but when you get to the more intermediate level, the reading and writing, again, doesn't matter so much that you know grammar topics. What matters is that you can use the language, that you can read in it, that you can write in it. And naturally, as you work on your reading and listening, as our focus of this section one here, listening and reading exposes you to those structures within the language. Now, as you do that, speaking and writing come in, and that's where you begin to practice those yourself. And there's not like a definite transition point here from listening and reading to speaking and writing, so let's just make one here. Now looking at the writing and speaking section here, I'm going to use these March language journal prompts, and let's go to March 15th because that is the day that I'm recording this. 15. Okay, you're going strawberry picking. Describe your strawberries, your experience picking them fresh off the strawberry bushes, how delicious they taste, where do you go, is there anyone with you, how long do you spend picking strawberries, what do you do with the strawberries when you get home. So the first thing I'm going to do is translate this. This isn't a perfect translation by any means. I'm sure there's many errors in here, but that's not really so important for this exercise because you still learn by doing this. So I'm going to paste this in here and see, okay, this is my question, translate question into target language, okay, and then I'm writing and my speaking practice is vous allez couler des phrases. Décris vos phrases, votre expérience en le couillant franchement sur les fourcières et à quel point elles sont délicieuses. Où vas-tu? Y a-t-il quelqu'un avec toi? Combien de temps passez-vous à cuire des phrases? Que faites-vous des phrases en rentrant à la maison? So you practice speaking, and I would respond. And for the response, again, totally okay if you're at any level to go over here and write how you would go strawberry picking. I went strawberry picking today. The strawberries were red. I don't know, whatever. Describe them. And then what you can do is copy that and paste that in here. And yes, this counts as your practice, copying and pasting. Who thought it could be so easy? And you're learning grammar all in this process. Why? Because, oh look, je suis, we have a verb conjugation. Je suis allé, a verb conjugation. We have our strawberries, right? Our agreement in noun and, oh man, what is this called again? Article, determiner? Something like that. And we're learning how to structure our sentences. We have our agreements, push, we have our S, our plural. We are just absorbing this while we're practicing. Of course, if you want to just write without translating, feel free. But I like to do it this way because I just like to check and I like to learn from the translations. This is an example of writing and speaking practice. And if you like this resource, it is in the study shop on my website. You can check that out there if you'd like. To conclude our speaking and writing section here, our speaking and writing practices are of course part of our reading and listening because we have to read to write and we have to listen to speak. Even if we're speaking to ourselves, we're listening to ourselves as we speak. So all of those are intertwined. And our speaking and writing, they help us with our fluency and our grammar, like I showed you in that document there. And as you learn, as you're writing as well, especially if you're using a non-translation approach and you're like, oh, how do I write this? And then you're like looking up words, or you're looking up specific grammar structures, or you might see something even in the translation approach where you're like, oh, I don't recognize that. And then you look it up and then you're like, oh, okay, this is cool. That's why that works that way. Or you write something and then you have someone look at it and they give you some corrections. And you're like, oh, I see I made a mistake here, but what's the mistake? Well, that leads you to look at that grammar topic. So maybe you made a noun and gender mistake in your writing and it's marked, and then you learn, oh, that's what that means. And this is a common mistake that I'm making. And maybe it's a grammar topic that you knew, maybe it's one that's new to you. Either way, you naturally acquire it instead of studying grammar books through and through and through and through and drill and kill. And instead, you're practicing and then learning grammar as a result. Of course, you can always still use grammar books. I do. But I also use this approach, and I try to spend more time in this approach and use the grammar as a supplement, because my goal is to be able to use the language, not necessarily to be able to recite every grammar concept to some random person. Okay, so that is speaking and writing in our fluency approach. Our bonus grammar tips. Let's start with tip one, which is basically assuming that you're taking some kind of course already, a college course, a course of some kind. And if you're doing this, you have restrictions in how you can study. So I want to start with this more restricted form of studying, and then we'll look at the other learners and styles and all of that as well. So for a college course, you are studying, you have to learn by those methods that are the opposite of the fluency approach of learning grammar and vocabulary and structure, and then learning how to speak and write and read and all of that. What you can do here, and what I've done, is use your downtime. So you use your breaks, you use any time that you have to build this fluency approach, building your own practice, essentially. And you can use any of these following tips to integrate into that, building your own practice as much as you can within your time constraints of your course. Tip two is to create your own language learning routines and habits and patterns and everything that makes you excited to learn language. So whether that is a daily journaling practice, that is using Duolingo, that is reading a comic book, whatever that is that gets you excited, just to take your time and have fun with it, because that's where you're going to really find your fluency, your flow within your language. Tip three is to use apps. So apps like Duolingo, and really Duolingo is the main one that I've used for language learning, the primary one. I tried a couple specifically Mandarin Chinese apps, but Duolingo is my go-to app. And I've used it for Spanish and French all the way through, and very, very helpful. And now for Mandarin, and it is that great fluency practice like we talked about in this video, and they have so many languages. So whether it's Duolingo or any app of your choice, use apps, because it takes away that, oh, I have to think about what to do, I have to get into this book and read and write. It's like on your phone, it's easy, do it wherever, whenever, and it's something that is accessible, you can commit to as one of your language habits. And tip four is to work with a tutor, and this is something that I've done at all levels of my language learning journeys, but not currently. And I've worked with tutors that I've just found through referrals and also through iTalki. It's a very, very helpful place to find a tutor. And this is especially helpful if you're at the speaking stage of your language. So say you have been studying on your own for some time now and you want to practice conversation. Working with a tutor specifically for conversation can be very helpful to expedite your practice, because you have
have someone who is skilled in teaching and not just using that language. And you can get feedback and get corrections. You can have different speeds. Think speak slowly, think speak quickly. They know the kind of mistakes that you're going to make, and they can really help you fast track your speaking practice, and that's very useful. And then of course a tutor is always useful at any stage of your language learning process. If you feel stuck or overwhelmed, or you just want a little something extra in there. Alright, so that is our final bonus tip, and that concludes our video. I'll see you guys back here for the next one. Bye guys!